So children, today we are going to learn about scattering of light, and in that the basic concept is your ninth class concept, that is Tyndall effect. What is Tyndall effect? Anyone? What is Tyndall effect?
When the light passes through the collider solution is known as Tyndall effect.
Yes, very true. When light passes through a colloidal solution, its path becomes visible, and that is known as Tyndall effect. So you have done three examples in class 9. The same examples we will repeat in the class 10th also. That is, when path of light is become visible, when light enters a dark and dusty room through a slit or ventilator. Suppose we have a storeroom, we have a small hole in that. For exhaust fan, generally we keep it. But suppose we don't have exhaust fan over there, when we enter in the daylight, we see that the light path is very clearly visible to us. The dust particles and the other particles are very clearly visible to us. So what is that? That is scattering of light by that colloidal particles, because air is a homogeneous mixture. But when air is near the atmosphere, last time also we have discussed, when air is near the atmosphere, earth atmosphere, then it becomes a colloidal solution. It behaves like a colloidal solution because dust particles are there. There are pollutants also. There are carbon particles, smoke particles. So they all make it a colloidal solution. But as we move above, it becomes a homogeneous mixture, true solution, right? It becomes pure. But near the atmosphere, near the earth surface, it behaves like a colloidal solution, specifically in Delhi city, metropolitan cities where the pollution is a lot, right? So path of light becomes visible when light enters a dark and dusty room through a slit or ventilator. We have also learned about that when path of light becomes visible, when we light passes through the dense canopy of trees in a forest. In films, in movies, you must have seen a very beautiful scene that there is a song and the light is coming through the trees, in between the trees, and that becomes very beautiful scenic beauty. What is that? Again, Tyndall effect, scattering of light by the colloidal particles, the dust particles. By that, we are able to see the path of light. Third, you have been an activity in form of the activity that you have been given three solutions, solution A, B, C. Please write down this question in your notebook. So the different colors of sky depends upon the pollutants and water vapors present in the atmosphere. As we have discussed just now, that in morning and evening time, due to the presence of mist particles and low temperature of sun and low temperature of atmosphere, these water vapors are bigger enough such that they can scatter the bigger wavelength of light, right? So in morning and evening, when sun rises, it appears to be which color? Red, blue or orange? Which color it appears?
Red.
It appears to be red color. Why? Because in morning time, the mist particles are bigger enough that they can scatter the light. Right? But as the sunlight rises, as the sun rises, these water vapors, these pollutant particles are break down and they become into the small particles. So which wavelength will be broken down by these small particles? Red, blue, violet, or all yellow, orange? Which color will be scattered?
Shyan?
I'm red.
What do you think? Red color will be scattered by fine particles or blue color will be scattered by fine particles?
I'm blue color.
Blue, indigo, purple color. These are the small wavelength we have learned. We have learned. See here. Also, we have learned that scattering of light is inversely proportional to the wavelength. We have learned there. So, more is the wavelength. Red color is having maximum wavelength. Yes or no? Red color is having maximum wavelength, so scattering of light of the red color is minimum. When it is there? In the morning and at the sunset time, when the water vapors get condensed and they are bigger enough, right? But in the sunrise time, in morning, mid of the noon time, 11 to 2 o'clock, The fine particles are present in the atmosphere and they scatter mainly the small wavelength of color. And which is the small wavelength? Which is the
violet.
Small wavelength of color?
Violet.
Blue, indigo, violet. So they scatter. So all they appear to be blue because scatter ho raha hai color. So it appears to be blue in color. The medium sized particles scatter mainly their red color. That is the longer wavelength. Even larger particles scatter all the colors of light. That is why it appears white, right? So even अभी हम देख रहे हैं ना कि रेनी सीजन है आज, आज थोड़ा सा क्लाउडी है, तो यू कैन सी नो कलर इज देयर. देयर इज क्लियर स्काई, इधर क्लियर स्काई और ब्लैक एंड व्हाइट क्लाउड्स आर विजिबल टू अस. व्हाई? बिकॉज द लार्जर पार्टिकल साइज इज देयर एंड दैट कैन स्कैटर ऑल द कलर्स अवे. दैट्स व्हाई इट अपीयर्स टू बी white in color. I hope this concept is clear to you, right? Let us understand this with the help of diagram. So yes children, you can understand from the diagram very well now. When sun rises or sunset, it is along the horizon, right? And the mist particles are bigger enough that they can scatter the red color, that is the longer wavelength of light. But when sun is overhead, that is near about 11 o'clock or 12 o'clock in summer season or winter season, this is less distance, and the less distance is scattered. Due to this, we have the fine particles in the atmosphere, and the sun either appears to be blue in color or it appears to be almost clear sky, white sky. Why? Because the all colors fades away and they are not reaching. But in the cloudy season, we are able to see the sky very white or black. This is because the largest particles of water vapors are there and they make the sky, all the colors are scattered away and the sky appears to be clear. Is it clear? The concept is clear. Now we will learn one activity that is known as C.V. Raman experiment. Yes, activity 11.3, right? See in your NCRT activity 11.3, please put the heading C.V. Raman experiment or the scattering of light. Write down the aim of the activity to show that light is consists of seven colors. To show that light is consists of seven colors with different wavelength. Rupendra, write down in your book, beta. Aim you have to write down here. To show that light is consists of seven colors with different wavelength. So Isaac Newton have proved that light is consists of seven colors, but he has not explained the concept of wavelength. Difference of wavelength and highest wavelength, let us understand from this activity. What we have done, children? We have done, you can do the labeling so that for better understanding in your NCRT. We have taken a tank, in that we have taken 2 liters of water. And in that 2 liters of water, you can see here, dissolve about 200 gram of sodium thiosulfate. Sodium thiosulfate, hypotonic solution we are making, because only 10% of salt we are adding in 2 liter of water, right? So sodium thiosulfate formula is Na2S2O3. Please write down in your book Na2S2O3. So as you can see, it is sulfur solution. So it has the speciality that when this sodium thiosulfate is dissolved in water, it makes the solution colloidal solution. Sulfur particles are bigger enough. What is the atomic number of sulfur particle? What is the atomic number of sulfur? Yes, correct, 16. And what is the atomic mass? 32. So the size of sulfur particles is bigger enough. Hame fine particles chahiye, bahut bade nahi chahiye, bahut chote nahi chahiye, right? So sulfur is medium sized particle. So that's why when we dissolve it in water, this becomes sulfur particles are scattered in it, and thus they make the water as the colloidal solution. Now what we have done, we have passed the white light, source of light, that may be a torch or white light, that source of light, S is source of light, right? Please label these in complete name so that for your better understanding. S is source, and here we have used a convex lens. So when converged light is falled on this convex lens, it makes it beam parallel to principal axis. Na? This is the rule. If the light source is at source, that is F, the beam will converge into the parallel beam of light, right? So it becomes parallel beam of light, and when this parallel beam of light passes through this colloidal solution, and we have put another lens over here before the screen, that is L2, convex lens. Again, L2 is a convex lens. Parallel beam of light gets converged because it's a converging lens. So parallel beam of light gets converged at a single point on the screen. So we are able to see one by one. To your surprise, we will see the first of all, the smallest wavelength color or largest wavelength color will appear on the screen. What do you say? Which color will appear on the screen? Smaller wavelength will scatter first or larger wavelength will scatter first?
Larger
कैसे हो जाएगा बेटा? Larger को तो time लगेगा, उसकी longer wavelength है. Wavelength किसकी small है?
Blue
की. तो उसको scatter करना easy होगा ना colloidal solution के, because the wavelength is small. So many particles are attacking on the small wavelength and they will get scattered easily. Agree? So first of all, the blue color appears, violet color, very faint violet color appears, then indigo, and blue is most scattered color such that this tank appears to be blue. So in this language, don't get confused in the NCRT. Beauty of NCRT is they have written the tank appears to be blue in three sides. Actually, we can see three sides only. Fourth side is opposite to us, right? Actually, it is having four sides only. So, charon taraf iske blue color dikhai dega. So, NCRT ki language se confused nahi hona. Three sides mean jo visible hume three sides hai, wahan blue dikhai dega, right? Now, the blue color is most scattered. Then appears yellow, orange, and last mein aayega red color because it has the maximum wavelength. Usko time lagega scatter hone ke, because maximum wavelength hai, wavelength badi hai, usko particles attack kar rahe hain continuously, but it is not scattering, so it will take some time, such that till then the smaller wavelength will appear and the last one appears to be red color. So with the help of this experiment, a very big setup have been set by C.V. Raman in Calcutta. He was having very big lab, and there he have done this experiment, proved the word that the all colors of seven colors are different wavelength. Is it clear? So this way your chapter is over. Any doubt?